Hi, I'm John, and in this IT Taster video, I'm going to discuss how we go about choosing the size of a system partition on a Windows server. Now, it's a question that appears a great deal in the tech forums, and the answers and advice vary. And the reason for this is there isn't a simple one-size-fits-all type answer. It depends on your server role and configuration, and there are a number of other things to consider, which I'll try to cover in this video, as well as some of the potential pitfalls to avoid. Let's begin by considering best practices. And for that, we first need to look up the Windows Server System requirements. Windows Server 2012 R2 system requirements state the estimated minimum disk space of 32 gigabytes. And we're reminded this is to be regarded as an absolute minimum. Windows Server 2012 R2 Essentials, on the other hand, recommends a 60GB system partition. Allocating the absolute minimum disk space for a server system partition is not a good idea, but this information gives us a good starting point to build on. A server system partition running out of disk space is a serious problem we need to avoid. Taking time to plan your server configuration is key, and forward planning plays a crucial role. Okay, so what sort of things do we need to consider when sizing a server system partition? Well, servers tend to have a longer service life than desktops, and throughout their life configurations can change. Servers can remain in use way beyond their plan refresh date, and this is because of things like legacy application support or other reasons, including finances. We also need to consider the roles and features to be installed on the server and allow sufficient space for additional roles and features that may need to be added in the future. Windows updates must also be taken into account. We need to be able to download and install important updates so we can patch security vulnerabilities, operating system issues and improvements. And we mustn't forget service packs, which are much larger and require more disk space. Running applications such as Microsoft Exchange, SQL and SharePoint Server are also going to demand more disk space. Although these applications are usually installed in a second partition, there are still files that go into the system partition. And again, these applications will have updates, fixes and service packs that we must allow for. There are also third-party software applications to consider. Again, these are likely to be installed in a second partition, but in some cases this may not be possible, and there will usually be some files installed in the system partition in any case. However, it's worthwhile having a chat with the application vendor. They may be able to offer some partition sizing advice based on their experiences of running the software application. Application upgrades and updates also need to be taken into account. A new version of a management information system, for example, is unlikely to be smaller and use less resources than the previous one. Antivirus software and antivirus management software is another important consideration. There are engine updates, product upgrades, and also very frequent virus definition updates that will require more disk space over time. Backup software and other applications, such as antivirus management software I've already mentioned, may also want to run a database such as SQL Express or even full-blown SQL. And there will be server hardware management software to manage and monitor the health of your server. And don't forget the software that manages the UPS too. And finally, there are server and application log files to take into account. Plenty of things to consider there. Now, updates to operating systems and applications only tend to get larger and consume more resources as time goes by. This could mean you may need to add more memory and in turn increase the size of the page file. Now, this can of course be moved to another partition, but it's still something to consider and take into account. And this brings us to the topic of virtualization. Virtualization makes it very easy to add more resources to a server. If we're running out of disk space, we can simply allocate more storage to our virtual machine. We can also add more storage to a physical server too, by adding more hardware. So if that's the case, why do we need to worry about sizing the system partition in the first place? Well, there are some issues to be aware of when adding additional storage to either a physical server or a virtual server. Although more disk storage can be made available to our server, the Windows server partition will need to be resized, expanded. If you have a C system partition and a D data partition that follows it, as in this example, the D partition is in the way. You cannot easily expand the C system partition. A method a good friend of mine uses is to create a dedicated volume for the system partition, whether physical or virtual. This can make later expansion of the system partition a little easier. So whether it's a physical server or a virtual server, it's important to plan ahead. I think it's better to be more generous allocating disk space at installation time, rather than having to run partition resizing tools on a mission-critical server further down the line. So to conclude, there's no one-size-fits-all answer when it comes to sizing a server system partition. I tend to favour an 80GB system partition for a Windows 2012 DC or file server system partition, and consider increasing depending on other roles and applications. Best practice for the server operating system is a good place to start. Always take best practice recommendations into account, and also take into account best practice for the applications you intend to run. Take time to plan, think ahead, and allow for important operating system and application updates, including future service packs. Adding more storage to a virtual machine isn't a magic fix. Operating system partitions must still be resized. If your system partition is followed by another partition, there's added complication. Consider creating a dedicated volume for the system partition. And remember, it's very easy to specify a generous system partition when you first build your server. It's a much more painful process to attempt to resize the system partition a year or two down the line when the server is running business critical applications. Well, that brings us to the end of this video. I hope you found it helpful. Please give a thumbs up if you did. And don't forget to subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. Comments are also welcome, and thanks for watching.